Hello everyone. Welcome to the first pre-class module. So the ways that these are going to work is I'm going to give you some short videos, usually not much more than 10 minutes, interspersed with little exercises which themselves are usually not more than one or two lines of code. And the idea is just to teach you the basics, and in class we'll do more complicated things. So I don't want you to get stuck on these for too long. And if you're having trouble, you should post a message on Discord or send me a message on Teams and we'll get you through it. So these are supposed to be things where you move along and just progress smoothly. And if you get stuck, we should get you unstuck. All right, but it's a beautiful day, and I have my friend Laser Cat with us along for the ride. So she's also going to be learning about our first topic, which is classes. All right, so let's dive into it. Now, first, I want to just review a couple things that we already know, but I want to get some vocabulary out there to give us context. So first, I've made a class which is called Driver, and that's just going to be the class that I use to run code. So it's going to drive the rest of my program. So what I'll do is I'll add a main to it. So I'll say public static void main string args. And this is just the incantation I have to do to make a main. We'll break down all these things a little more as we go on. But let's just remember, okay, so we have available to us in Java what are called some primitive types. So for example, I can have int x equals 10. I can have double y equals 95.5. Okay, so int x is a whole number. Y is a decimal number of type double. And of course, we can also have char c equals capital A. Why not? So these are examples of what are called primitive types. And so here we have a type int. The name of it is x, and it is 10. So we call x an instance of int, and it has the value 10. We call y an instance of type double, and it has the value 95.5. Okay. So x and y are instances of this type int. But they certainly don't represent all possible instances, right? I can have as many ints or as many doubles as I want, as long as they fit into memory. Okay. So, of course, I could also define an int z, which is equal to negative 60. Okay, so these are two different instances of the type int. Now, why am I making such a deal about this? We'll see in a second. But let me now move on to a more custom meta type of variable. So I can actually design my own variable types with classes. So far, this class has just been a weird syntax that we've had to have to make this all work. But let's actually make another class and see how to use them a little more. So let me make a class called Student. And we'll just make a simple example of a student. So let's make a variable type that's student. So that's called a class. And a student can have more than one piece of information about it. So it doesn't just have to be a single number or a single character now. Now we can actually say things like, well, the student has an age. So let's say private int age. Student has a first name. So let's say private string first name. And the student has a last name. So let's just start with that. Okay, cool. So now we have a variable type that can actually hold three pieces of information. So let me clean this up, and I'm going to go to the main here. As long as these are in the same folder, driver will know about students. So I can say, okay, student Chris. So Chris is an instance of the type student, where the type is actually a class. So again, a class is just a meta variable that holds other variables, but we can still use it. Just like we said, int x equals 10, we can say student Chris equals something, okay. Now, the equals something is a little bit less clear what we have to do. It's going to be a little more complicated than just saying equals one thing. We have three things here. So you might think, okay, well, maybe I'll say student Chris is equal to, so we have the age, first name, last name. So you might think, okay, well, 31 Chris trailing, right? So maybe I'll just have three things. Turns out that's not the syntax. We need to do something else. So we're going to need to use something called a constructor. And a constructor is a method which is public, which means that we can access it from another class. And it's going to be void, so it's not going to return anything. And that's implied, actually. So what we say is just public, and we don't even need the void. We just say public student. And that's the method. Okay. So every time, now if I go back here, I say student Christ is equal to new student. This is the way I declare an instance of type student. And when I say new student, it's going to call this method. So this is called the constructor. So when I say new student, it's going to call this on my instance. Okay. So actually, we have a fancy name for an instance of type class. It's called an object. So Chris is an object of type student. So let me change my vocabulary here. So this is actually, I'm calling this method to, I will call this method to initialize a new object of type student. So Chris is an object of type student. Cool. But I don't see anywhere that I'm setting this information, age, first name, and last name. Well, here's where you can actually pass along parameters to the constructor. So let me say int a string f string l. And now I'll say age equals a, first name equals f, and last name equals l. Okay, and of course you should always do your doc string on this method, right? So I'll remind myself that a is the age of student I'm making, f is the first name of student I'm making, and L is the last name of student I'm making. And the reason I chose different names for these parameters is because I wanted to be able to tell the difference between the parameter and the actual what we call instance variable. So these are instance variables of my object. They belong to a particular object. And if I call this age, I might get confused about, well, which age am I referring to here? Is it the parameter, or is it this local variable? And it actually warned us here. The assigned variables never gets used, so it's getting a little confused. So let's keep it as an A. Okay. So now when I call the constructor, I can actually pass along this information, and it'll get saved. So let's say a new student, he's 31, his first name is Chris, his last name is Trailer. Okay, cool. So that's going to call the constructor, and it's going to set those variables, which now belong to the Chris object. All right, so these are instance variables. Notice how they don't have static, like the main did, or some other methods did. So this has a static here. This means it belongs to the class. But if I don't have static, it means it belongs to a particular object. So I can also say student Celia, so that's my wife, equals new student 30, Celia Litovsky. And actually, her set of variables for age, first name, and last name are going to be different. They belong to her, and the constructor is run on her object. All right, so what if I now go to print these out? So what if I say system.out.println Chris, and then system.out.println Celia? All right, so let's run the driver. Okay, so when I print out Chris, it says student at 15db9742. I want to print Celia, it says student at 60.06.69c. So those of you who have me 173 or who have seen hex and binary before might recognize that these are hex codes. And they're actually just giving us the address, the 32-bit address of these objects in memory. Blah, blah, blah. Okay. It's probably not what I want when I print these out. It's just telling me where they are in memory. I probably want to print something a little more informative than that. So maybe I'll just print out maybe the first name and their age instead. Okay, so I can define a custom thing to do when these get printed. And for that, I have to define an instance method, so a method that belongs to a particular object, called toString. So it's going to return a string that is the string that should get printed when we call print. So I'll say public string toString, and I'll return maybe the first name, I'll say name first name, and then age colon age. Okay. So when I do this, it's going to know the toString is going to be referring to these variables, which are part of the object. So now, when I print these out, it's going to print Chris, age 31, Celia, age 30. Okay, so when it calls this, it pulls out the particular instance variables of this object, and it puts them together into this string. Okay, so that's cool. Now we really have these meta types, and they're storing different information. So these two objects store different information, but they're both organized into the student class type structure. Okay, now just to show you, we're not restricted to these only two methods, constructor and toString. We can define any method we want, which is an instance method. So I could, for example, say public string get full name, and maybe I actually want to return the first name plus the last name. So let's say return first name plus a space plus the last name. So now if I get the full name, so I can, instead of saying print Chris or print Celia, I can say print Chris dot get full name and print Celia dot get full name. So this is actually going to call this instance method on the particular object that we're calling it on. Okay, so when I say Chris.getFullName, it's going to go here, it's going to pull out Chris's first name and Chris's last name, and it's going to add them together into a string separated by a space. When I call it on Celia, it's actually going to pull out Celia's first name and Celia's last name and add them together separated by a space. So now when I run the driver and I see I'm calling these methods, I say it gets Chris Traley and Celia Tusky. So this is the syntax. It's the object dot the method that you're trying to call. Okay, so now I'm going to want you to make a method. And actually, we can change things by the method too. So maybe I'll say, I'll say public void chop off character from name. I probably wouldn't want to do this too often, but just as an example here, so I'll say first name equals first name dot substring 0 first name dot length minus 1. So this will chop off a character from my first name and then save the new values. So I'm just showing you can actually change these instant methods when you call them. So now if I say Chris dot chop off character, and now I print, I'll say it prints out Chris Traley, okay? And you know, if I call this twice, Chris.chopoff character from name, I should only have CHR on my first name. So you can actually, these methods can actually be used to mutate the state of these objects. So they can actually change the variables that they contain. So now I'm going to have you do a little exercise where you create a method to celebrate someone's birthday. So it should add one to their age.